All right, after Telefero, Mr. Telefero TV, my new website drops March 1st. It's MrTelefero.com. For you guys that can't spell my last name, it's MrT.com. And we ready. All right. We are talking Jimmy Butler, Dwayne Wade, Fred Hoiberg, the coach of the Chicago Bulls, and we are talking Rajon Rondo. All in one. All right, I'm going to be honest with you. I thought Fred Hoiberg was a bad hire from the beginning. I really did. I just don't think he fits the system. I thought there were other great candidates out there at the time. Not coming to the top of my head, but there definitely was better candidates out there for this job. He was the hot pick, the sexy pick at the time. And I don't think this decision was really thought through. I really don't think it was thought through. And the Bulls are paying for it. The Bulls are literally paying for it. Fred Hoiberg was coming out of Iowa State. And, I mean, Iowa State was in the midst of a good season, and he was just a hot pick. Here's what has happened. Jimmy Butler and Dwayne Wade called out a team yesterday. It was like the team not giving effort, and they're just not going hard. Rajon Rondo took to his Instagram account to say, look, the people I used to look up to, my OGs, Kevin Garnett of the world, the Paul Pierce of the world, the Ray Allens of the world, they would never go to the media to call their team out. And everybody, including self, I did a blog on this yesterday, I was like, Rajon Rondo was right. This is unlike D-Wade. D-Wade, you see what D-Wade's problem is? This is his first time not being in Miami. He's used to things being done in a system, having a consistent head coach where there was a great relationship between the head coach and Eric Spoelstra and Dwayne Wade as the player, Pat Riley, everything. He was used to that consistency, but the reality of the situation is the Miami, he didn't want to pay Dwayne Wade. Dwayne Wade is used to that system, knowing the teammate's going to go hard. Even if Udonis Haslam, all the way down to the end of the bench, has to come into a game unexpectedly, he knows that everybody's going to give it their all. Dwayne Wade's in this new system. He's like, man, y'all dudes don't want it bad enough. I'm 35 years old. I shouldn't be one of the guys going the hardest, winning this game the most, still having to put up 33 a night. Jimmy Butler went for 42 in that game, and they both called out the teammates. Said the teammates don't want it enough. Rondo said, my OGs like KG would never do that. So Coach Fred Hoiberg chimed in today, and he said, it's unacceptable to air your grievances out through the media. We talked about it in our very first meeting. If you have issues, sit behind closed doors and talk about it. We move forward and we get better because of it. From that standpoint, yeah, it was disappointing, but then again, we got to move forward. Let's just be honest. I don't think Fred Hoiberg knew what he was signing up with. And Dwayne Wade is a class act. So I'm not going to go blame Dwayne Wade. And to give Dwayne Wade and Jimmy Butler credit, Dwayne Wade does give this game a lot. Jimmy Butler is having an incredible season starting the All-Star game. They're probably not getting enough out of the teammates. And let's be honest, they probably went to the teammates first. But you just don't do that. You don't cross that line and go to the media. The only thing about Rondo making the comments is the fact is that Rondo made the comments, and he's a guy who hasn't had a great history with his coaches. So it's kind of ironic that Rajon Rondo made the comments, but he was right. Anyways, to get to the grit of the story, Fred Hoiberg benched Jimmy Butler and Dwayne Wade because of the things I said, and they had to come off the bench. They didn't start, all right? They're playing, but they didn't start. I'm going to be honest with you. I think Jimmy Butler and Dwayne Wade are both fed up with this team. Jimmy Butler's a free agent coming up soon. He'll probably be looking for those walking papers. Dwayne Wade has already said, if Butler's not here, I have to really think about what I got to do. And let's not beat around the bush. Wade's like, man, I'm already having a hard time getting a lot out of you guys. You think I'm going to stick around with, and the only guy who's going hard is going to be out of here? It's the realization of the situation. Jimmy's actually out of in contract for a few more years, so I don't know exactly how he plans to get out of Chicago, but I'm pretty sure Jimmy Butler's going to want out next year. Might try to ride this one out, get out the door next year. The Chicago Bulls team is a mess, and as I speak, literally as I come up with this vlog, Jimmy Butler just literally checked out of a game himself. It is a mess in Chicago. Yes, he checked out of a game after he committed a foul. The coach had no one to bring in at the time. He just checked out of a game. Alfred Telefero, Mr. Telefero TV. It's time to move on from Fred Hoiberg. It was a bad hire. He's lost his team. And it's also time to just reconsider the structure of this team. They have no identity, and see where to go next. Alfred Telefero, Mr. Telefero TV, thank you for the time, love, and support. I don't take it for granted. Salute. I'm out.